Have you ever wondered how a news department works? You haven't wondered that, but perhaps you have. Where do the stories come from? How do we get them on all the how do we get them on the air? All this week, Dr. George joins us with a special report on how we do the news. And tonight he begins with a look at the people you do see in front of the camera, the Eyewitness News anchor team. This is the part that we know the best.
Welcome to broadcast news.
Yes.
You know, here at Eyewitness News, we have 10 regular anchors. 10 heroes and heroines, too. Every day, you'll see them sitting here telling you about the tragedies, the joys, the developments, the changes, bad news and good news. And we thought you'd like to see them in a different light, not as news anchors, but as people, beginning with the team who arrives here before the sun's up.
Go ahead and check on it anyway, and I'll ask her whether she's going to use it. And if it's still going on and it's good, we could send Elaine down there. If not, well, at least use a VO or something on it.
Full details on these stories and the rest of the news coming up at 6:30 on Eyewitness News this morning.
Eyewitness News reporter Mark Coogan is live in Oakland this morning.
When the 6:30 a.m. show is off the air, the anchors are off to cover stories for other newscasts. In fact, all of the Eyewitness News anchors have dual jobs.
Nancy Popkins writing that.
There's a story on the wires. What I'm trying to do by making a bunch of calls is advance that a little bit.
Anchors also do mini-docs, special multi-part reports on various subjects.
Two young men that I knew very well for 20 years are dead.
He's just talking about the fact that basically that you've got this war going on in the streets and the neighborhoods.
I'm working on a mini-doc. I'm on prostitution.
I thought all an anchor ever did was to pick up the script and read it.
Not this anchor. Maybe some. I don't know of anybody around here that does.
Well, the business report, you want me to write the stock?
Yeah. This is not something most people know, but when I first came here about 20 years ago, Harold Green was my producer-director. He was. Harold Green. And you know I'm an old man, and he is actually 74 years old. Harold, you must be at least that old to have done all of the things that you've done.
I feel like it's
amazing. What else have you done here?
Well, let's see, I've been the...
Besides being an anchor.
Yeah, all right. I've been the producer of the news, a writer on the news.
Yes.
I have been a reporter.
One and a half?
Well, no, it'll be like a minute 30. But do we have to drop the FDA thing still?
No.
I have been the sportscaster here. I've done the morning show, AM Los Angeles.
Those stories and more on Eyewitness News tonight.
And I produced and created a show called Hollywood Close-Up that ran on the weekends here. And occasionally I've swept up just before I left.
Why do they need makeup? Both men and women. There has to be a reason.
The light is so bright out there that it takes all the color out of a person's face. And she gives it a little more color than it really has because it's going to be blasted with so much light that it needs a little extra.
You can't beat perfection. You just got to wipe them down.
You can't beat perfection. No.
This is how I get the real tan over here, George. This is it.
Do I look better now? Like many of the professionals in this extremely demanding job, it can be very difficult juggling career and home life.
It's terribly difficult.
Yes.
When I'm here, I feel guilty that I'm not at home. But if I stay at home too long and I think I should be here, then I feel guilty too. It's just a matter of priorities.
Being an anchor news person can be very stressful, particularly when breaking news happens close to airtime.
I think one of the most interesting times news-wise was when we had the earthquake.
Mm-hmm.
And you were busy.
Really, that's a very enjoyable situation. If you're not afraid of saying the wrong thing, it's really fun to work without a script and to be able to just tell people what's been happening.
If something comes out of our mouth that's incorrect, it's really our responsibility.
And people blame you for it.
Well, yeah, because
sure
they don't know of all these other people that are working. So, yeah, it's important that we try our darndest to make sure that it's correct by the time we do it.
George, don't bother with
Thank you.
He's thinking?
He's deep in thought, preparing tonight's commentary, which obviously nobody's going to be able to read. Look at that.
I don't know if you're going to be able to understand it either. I don't even know what it's about. I don't quite get it.
I think coming from you, people will understand it.
I do too. Bruce Hershenson, of course, is a commentator here at Eyewitness News. He is considered one of our on-air specialists. The Franklin scale of 1 to 10 is the work of our cinema critic, Gary Franklin. We have two medical specialists, Dr. Dean Adele and Dr. Art Uleen. Our music news is left in the hands of Francesca Cappucci. Henry Alfaro helps you with consumer problems in his Seven on Your Side segment. Pam Thompson covers Hollywood as our entertainment reporter. And then there's our wayward travelers, Fred and Elmer.
This is Fred Anderson.
And this is Elmer Dills, somewhere in the jungles of Costa Rica.
Tomorrow we'll show you what it takes to be a news camera person. And we'll take you to the heart of the news operation, the assignment desk. I learned more things about how the newsroom works while I was doing this series, Paul.
I'll bet you did, because I saw you running around there for at least a couple of weeks with the camera crew and everything.
Yeah. It was fun.
I'll bet it was.
It made all of us a little self-conscious because we're not used to having cameras up there.
That's
you got
true.
Pictures of some of us eating and doing
shirts
says, hey,
unbuttoned,
take
things
that camera
like that.
Away.
All right, good. See you tomorrow night.
Thanks,
right.
George.
Okay. And the news will continue now at 6 o'clock with Harold and Tawny. Dr. George on set with us again tonight to continue his special report on how we do the news. And tonight we go to the beginning of the news gathering process, that is the assignment desk and those Blue Crew minicam crew vans. And here's Dr. George. George?
People always ask, how do I get a story on the news? They call us
off
on
fast,
the phone.
You're right.
Now they'll find out. Because there are literally dozens of people involved in each and every story that you see here on Eyewitness News. But all stories begin at the assignment desk. That's where the decisions are made about what stories to cover and how best to cover them. And it's where the crews and the reporters start their day.
And that aid's being supported by Block and by Antonovich.
So we need the news conference shot, then the demonstration.
Eyewitness News assignment desk.
At Chapman College in Orange.
We have been designated as the only crew that can go inside and shoot.
The assignment editor, along with the executive producer, decide what stories to cover each day.
Is there any reason 29 has to be at Chapman College tonight?
Yes.
Why? Can you come talk to me, please, because the plan for tonight has changed.
Use a beta cam, which is a camera that just requires one person to run it. The recorder's in the back, the camera's in the front, and run around town and gather the news.
Good morning. Is everybody ready?
Yeah, Minicam 9, we're leaving City Hall. We're going to head on down to the Coliseum Commission.
Listen, my name's Mark Coogan. I'm with Channel 7, KABC-TV.
Oh, you got to get the other side. Otherwise, people don't have a fair shot at the story. They don't have any understanding of what went on. You give them one-sided information, first of all, it's wrong. It's just plain morally wrong. Second of all, people have certainly other options to watch the news, and pretty soon they'll find out they're not getting a straight story or an honest story, and they'll depart.
I got a gig with Cappucci at 4 o'clock in Beverly Hills.
Throughout the day, scanners are monitored to keep track of what police and fire departments are working on. When a news story breaks, the assignment editor must get a crew and a reporter on the scene with as much information as possible.
Mark Brown is on 804, the writer on Mark Brown's remote.
I think that we all have a lot of respect from the people that are out there.
Yes.
They know us. They know we're going to be fair to them. They may not like what we say, but they know we're going to be fair, and they know they're going to get a fair shake, and that it's going to be a balanced report.
Murder, which occurred on February 25th this year.
In the field, the reporter and crew work together to get the information and visuals to tell the story.
The important thing is to make sure the reporter gets what she wants, which is probably the hardest thing to do. Because when she can't write verbally, we've got to try to visualize for her.
I got a good shot, so I'm happy, thanks.
The reflector is used to reflect the sun, as much sun as I can get on her face, to brighten up her face when I've got a very bright background.
Bob Banfield, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
The field crew and reporter are always working against the clock, particularly with breaking news. When time permits, the reporter brings the tape in. He or she will sit at a computer and write a voice track.
Here's a track, 3, 2, 1. It was a murder that shocked the city.
Then the editor puts the words and visuals together to create a news story. When time is of the essence, tape is fed to the station.
This is transmission to unit calling in.
The engineers in transmission help the crews in the field find the strongest signal to feed in their tape.
Hi, Alice. Minicam 11 on Santiago.
Have some tape to feed.
Now they should only feed what we need to use to get turned around for an update remote.
Pass on to Mark Brown that we're looking for a 6 o'clock wrap.
Transmission is also responsible for all of our live reports.
I'm Joe McMahon reporting live in Santa Monica. Back to you in Hollywood.
All right, Joe. Good report.
Art Rascone is going to come up at the 5 o'clock hour to do a live remote from this particular site.
Reporting live from Beverly Hills, Art Rascone, Channel 7 Eyewitness News. Paul?
All right, Art, thanks.
Thank you, Art.
Thanks to ever-advancing technology, we are able to get news to you from anywhere. Right now, we are one of the few stations in town to have a satellite truck. This half-million-dollar communications wonder has its own generator, editing system, phone system, and, most impressive, it can send signals directly to satellites in space. This truck can literally go anywhere in the world and feed video to our station.
Hello, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hello,
guys,
hello,
you're doing great. You're doing great.
All right. No, what? We got to move the truck. I'm going to open
tomorrow,
up.
Tomorrow, breaking news. You'll see and hear just what it takes to cover a major story in Southern California.
Professional cleanup crew to come in.
And that's tomorrow. But there's going to be much more the rest of the week, including a look at how writers and editors take raw video and make a news story, and a special look at our sports and weather departments. How do you like it so far?
Well, I'll tell you what, I've been doing this for a lot of years, and I just sat here transfixed. You really did a good job on that.
Yeah.
And the cameraman that shot that for you,
yes,
did a wonderful job.
Yes, Marco Robolino did a lovely job. Teamwork, that's the essence of what we saw tonight. That's what makes
tomorrow
this place work.
More.
Thank you. Look forward to it, George. That wraps it up for us. Well, it's time once again to take you behind the scenes of Eyewitness News. We pull back the curtain tonight and show how we do it. Dr. George joins us to continue his special report with a look at how the station covers breaking stories. This is the best part of all,
this
I think.
This is the best part. Well, outside of sports and weather, which comes on Friday.
Well, that's also good.
But, and in the television news business, we cover a lot of stories on a variety of topics. But nothing is more important than getting major news to you as quickly as possible. Now, what you never see is what our crews and reporters go through to cover a breaking story. That is, until now. But on any given day, breaking news always has first priority. Now, for example, one day my cameraman and the producer for this series were on their way to a truck explosion in Santa Monica Freeway.
Okay, stay behind the first ambulance. You'll see some other vehicles and things like that. Okay, there'll be some officers directing you in. Just go in slow, okay?
They had planned to show you how our news crews cover breaking stories. But as it turned out, they were the only ones there. And so this series had to take a back seat to the breaking news. When reporter Mark Brown and the crews arrived on the scene, well, we'll show you what happened.
You know, it took us so long to get here because they would not allow us to come up on any ramp here at all. Yeah. We've passed under the freeway, we've gone back this way, we've gone all the way around to try to get back on the other side. Then we see you going up Pico, and it's like, what is this? It was unbelievable.
By the time we pulled up to this story, we were very close to our on-air slot.
Yes, I'm here at the accident scene and would like to set up a signal.
When I was setting up a signal, I put the mast up in the air. It is a 40-foot mast that extends out of a shaft inside the truck. And this is so we can go live. And on this particular day, I set up to Mount Wilson.
Okay, I'm gonna pan.
Okay.
There is a person back in transmission who is accepting the signal.
I did not see you at Santiago at all. Let's see if we can get it into Wilson.
All right, no, what? We gotta move the truck. They're gonna open up the number 1 and 2 lanes.
We were getting ready to go live, and they wanted us to move to the opposite side of the freeway. And so we had to physically move all the equipment that we had just set up about 30 seconds before air.
Got a picture, Greg.
I got an audio check.
Okay, we'll cut separate tapes. That'll make it easier. All right. Give me a fire for about 15 seconds.
And if I need to, I will get back to you. I'm going to power down now.
Just for your information, United Pumping does not handle compressed gas. That's what you're dealing with down there.
Y'all can trick them? What are you trying to tell us?
Get out.
Turn up the IFB.
The IFB is an interrupt frequency broadcast from the studio.
which gives us off air. It also gives us the studio where the AD interrupts, giving us cues.
I still can't hear you guys. Could you, somebody say something, please?
13 minutes.
And,
everything that I had ordered cut is going to be used on the clock.
No, they'll have something.
Environmental Transportation Service. We'll use some of the tape that Chuck set in, and we'll resume him feeding in a couple minutes again.
10-4, I'll let them know. Thanks.
Being in the truck, I have communication with the studio that the people who are outside the truck and getting ready for the remote don't have, so I have to give them information.
Tell them right now.
It's a minute remote.
It's from Walter Supply.
They're
going
to give him some shots of the fire and traffic.
This specific assignment created problems because we had to move camera locations four different times, which creates a tremendous problem when you're working with a deadline.
What, can we get real close to the thing then and just switch around?
If I move one more time, Mark, I'm going to pull your mustache out by each little hair.
The tanks are unstable in the condition that they're in now, and we are waiting for a professional cleanup crew to come out here and to put the tanks into a neutral condition.
Recapping our top story at this hour, the I-10 freeway in Santa Monica is backed up for miles in both directions, this following a fiery gas explosion near Centinela Avenue. Channel 7's Mark Brown is standing by at the scene with his live report. How does it look out there, Mark?
Well, we have some good news to report now. What kind of danger was traffic in, the people who were driving by at that?
The people that were driving by were in quite a bit of danger at that time. There was explosions. There was...
Mark Brown, reporting live. Now back to you.
Mark, we'll get back to you in just a bit. As we push on here, the Bolivian government is...
Thanks.
Right now, we're doing it at the top of this segment. It's got to come now.
Tomorrow, we'll go back into the newsroom and show you how videotape is transformed into a news story by editors and writers. And we'll take you where the excitement really happens, into the control room, while Eyewitness News is on the air. But that's not all. On Friday, you'll have a chance to see what our sports and weather people are really like. And you just might be surprised.
What do you mean by that? You just showed us the most interesting and exciting part of this business.
That is the
true.
Best. That is the best.
And maybe by watching this, I hope that people will have more of an understanding about what we do and how the finished product finally gets there.
That's the idea, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And get the information. Thank you, George. We'll see you back here tomorrow night.
Yes, indeed.
In the meantime, the news continues at 6 o'clock with Harold and Tawny. Okay, we have looked forward to this. Dr. George joins us now to continue his special report on how we do the news. And tonight, you'll meet the in-house professionals who put it all together and get Eyewitness News on the air. Tough as it is some days, we get it on the air. Here's George.
Get that energy level up because we're going to need it today. All this week, we've shown you how reporters and crews cover stories in the field. But that's just the beginning of the news gathering process. The facts must be written, the tapes edited, and all the stories have to be structured into a show. It is a complicated and very stressful process, which takes dozens of devoted professionals to make it happen every single day.
What? Let me hear Gillespie one more time. Go back to 2334.
Once a story is shot on videotape, it's left in the hands of the news writer.
You have to go find the resources to write the stories, whether it be talk to a reporter or find wire copy or make phone calls to police agency. And of course, we have to look at the tape.
They launched a satellite and it didn't go up into the right orbit.
The writer is then assigned to a tape editor, and based on the video and the facts about the story, the writer and the editor figure out how to squeeze it all into a story that runs anywhere from 30 seconds to 2 minutes.
We sit with an editor and edit the tape to exactly how we, specifications we want it, how long we want each shot, what we want to show, and then we come back and write the story to match that so that it all makes sense.
We're just going to use 30 seconds of this stuff. The tree giveaway outside of the Capitol, without the governor, and I'll write something about Arbor Day.
In TV news, you're matching the words with the pictures. And that's the critical lesson that everyone who comes from print and radio has to learn. And it takes some time to do that.
And then at 6:30, I wanted to go with the tornado stuff.
That's a good lead.
Each show has a producer who assigns the writers to the stories. And it's his or her responsibility to make sure the show gets on the air on time and gets off on time. And that all the latest news is in that show.
The live shot is dead. We're going to use the VO. She's sending in the interview.
We're always looking to make sure that the 6 o'clock has the very latest and not just with the 4 o'clock.
So if you're going to put it in, we're going to need to put it in after 6:30.
Okay.
It's supposed to start at 6.
Get the facts. Get them on the air. If it's that kind of story that people need to know about right away, you got to get it to them.
As showtime nears, stress levels rise and tensions mount.
Run the live remote for weather. 28.
You know, it's looking really depressing.
There's something going on.
Eyewitness News.
Everything that I can to reduce the amount of chemicals.
Jack, how are we doing?
Right now, we're doing it at the top of this segment. It's got to come now.
After the script is written, it's sent to the show via computer. It's also sent to our closed caption encoder for our hearing-impaired viewers. The script is broken down, and apprentices get to practice their 100-yard dash to the control room, much like in the hit movie Broadcast News.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and...
Up on cue.
Good afternoon, I'm Harry Cunningham.
I'm Laura Diaz, and this is Eyewitness News.
There is another team of professionals who get the news to you. They are the control room team, the director, associate director, technical director, stage manager, and audio engineer.
Hello.
Pick one.
It might be the Raiders' biggest reverse market.
Okay, yeah, we do want it. In DeVore?
Reporting live from Oakland, this is Mark Coogan. Now let's go back to Los Angeles.
Take three.
Snow Hill. Harold will do it.
Put some new stuff in there, that's why I'm...
Turn to more
drop
sound.
Drop it. Change Sky Ron. Stand by voiceover, then more sound. Coming back to three.
22 is dead. Laura does 22A. We got some great snow stuff coming in. We need a little more time for weather tonight.
Start.
I think Mr. Fu is on the endangered species list.
This time the Raiders are going with a double reverse. Here in the Southland, reaction seems to be, so what?
Sound cool.
I was going to show the radar here and talk about it too.
Okay, because then we're going to have to make a quick switch upstairs, but I think we can do it. 30 seconds. It's only 30.
Three off of this, you'll be going back to the two anchors and the remote monitor.
I'll tell you about the other one. Yeah, I know, but we're going to have to switch them. I think I know how to do it.
Item 32 is dead.
Uh-oh.
So put the T-33 on cassette 3.
Coming out in 7,
yeah,
6,
anybody camera 1,
5,
standing by camera
4,
1. I need a,
3,
after Dallas
2,
theme, I need a line.
1,
listen to
and
standing by 1.
Take 52.
Up on 1.
Tomorrow we'll take you where no non-sportsman has gone before. Behind the scenes of our sports department.
Oh, no!
And last, but definitely not least, a trip to our weather department, where you'll see how advanced technology helps us keep you dry, cool, warm, and ready for anything. We did save the best for the last, of course.
This was a wonderful segment today because it wasn't exaggerated, and it does, I think, show the tension. I remember once in college having to direct a show, and I swore after that one little half hour I would never do it again. There's so much nervous energy going on in the booth.
Not one bit
no
of
one
this
ever
was
sees.
Put on.
No.
You know, this is just the way it is. Every single program.
All the people that run down with those scripts are all skinny. Because they're working.
They
are you sure you want to go into the sports department? Are you sure you want to go into that cage?
He's done it already.
We're going to try it tomorrow.
Right. Okay.
Thank you, George. That was great.
Thanks, George.
And the news continues right now with Harold and Tawny.
Well, as Dr. George said, he is going to save the best until the last. He wraps up his series on the news tonight with a look behind the scenes in the sports and weather departments where most of us are afraid to even walk in the door for fear of what might happen.
Weather department,
the weather
sure.
department, you're welcome anytime. You know
but
that.
In sports, huh?
But you know what? It's Friday. It's the weekend. And since it is Friday, most people look forward to a weekend of sports and hopefully a weekend of great weather. So we decided this is the perfect time to show you my domain, the weather department.
Ooh.
And we'll sneak you into the Eyewitness News locker room, better known as sports.
A
The name of the game is sports, at least for Jim Hill, Rick Lozano, and Todd Donahoe. For Jim, football was a way of life for 8 years as safety for the Green Bay Packers. Rick played basketball in college, but since coming to Eyewitness Sports, he's found other interests.
And Lee, give it your best shot, buddy. Here we go. Ow!
Wahoo! While Todd wrestled and played football in school, he now takes it to the hoop. The sports department has cut out its own little niche. There are three producers who, along with the talent, write and edit all the sports.
You know what cheerleaders look like in 1957?
And there are four desk assistants who spend their days watching game after game after game. What a life.
Oh, no. That guy, he threw that ball right at the buzzer.
But not all sports stories are on the court, field, water, or track.
Have you met the good doctor?
No, I haven't.
Yeah, doctor.
Thank you. Dear friend, good friend. Occasionally, they enjoy a quiet sit-down interview, like this one Jim did with Kareem.
Are we ready, sir?
We're ready. Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. Before we start talking about basketball or anything, I'm interested in your episode on 21 Jump Street.
I have the best job in the world, and I work with the best people in the world.
You and I both. You and I both.
Yeah.
Huh?
You better believe it.
Jim is right. We do have the best people here at Eyewitness News. And some of the finest are right here in the weather department.
By late in the day, watch it, it'll move. There we go, rapidly on toward the desert areas.
Each day, Dallas Rains, Johnny Mountain, Rick DeReyes and I attempt to master our very sophisticated satellite computers so we can bring you the most accurate weather possible.
George, what's the weather going to be tomorrow?
It looks as though those clouds are coming down. There are already clouds. And our weather department is so well-staffed, we even have our own computer whiz, better known to you as reporter Fred Anderson. Each day, we all pull together satellite pictures, forecast maps, and graphics to help you see what the future holds weather-wise.
That's where I find the weather every day, under the table.
The satellite maps come from a weather research firm. They send new information 24 hours a day. But even with all this high-tech wizardry, every day I make a stop at the National Weather Forecast Office. After I make my daily dash to the studio, I still like to make a last-minute check, the old-fashioned way. A phone call.
It's 6 o'clock. What's the latest weather?
Then it's showtime.
Yay,
good friend. Once in a while, we do live reports on the weather from the place it happens, outdoors. Sometime it's up, up, and away in our helicopter, Air 7. And I can tell you, it is really a thrill. I hope this week has been a thrill for you, seeing what it takes to put the Eyewitness News on the air. Paul, hope everybody enjoyed it as much as we have.
We sure
we did.
And you look
sure
like you're having fun doing it, too.
Always.
Yeah.
Yes. Many years now.
Tell Mountain to quit stealing the popcorn and taking it into the weather office, will you?
That would be good.
That would be nice.
That'd be good.
Yeah.
Thank you, George.
Thank you.
Great week.
Delightful.
Mm-hmm.
Good weekend. See you at 11 o'clock.
You too.
See All right. News continues now at 6 with Harold and Tawny.
Thanks, Paul. The State Agriculture Department announces that the medfly war is far from over and malathion spraying will last indefinitely. And a leader of the Manson family makes a personal plea for freedom.
Thank you. Thanks.
Former hostage Frank Reed returns home to the United States. More violence breaks out on a high school campus in Los Angeles. And local Catholic leaders hope for a diplomatic breakthrough between Mexico and the Vatican.
Next on Eyewitness News. Number one in Southern California.